In this video, we're looking at a simple pendulum, and we're given the mass of the bob, that's 180 grams, and the length of the string, that's 1.5 meters. But this time we're told the string is very light, and it has a breaking strength of 2.2 newtons. So the main part of the problem is to figure out how high can we release this pendulum before the string is going to break. And the first thing we have to realize is that the maximum tension in the string occurs at the bottom of the trajectory. And there's actually two different reasons for this. Let's get a force diagram done and then we'll talk about it. So in our force diagram, we have one vector pointing up on the pendulum bob, and that's the tension in the string. And we have one vector pointing down, and that's the weight of the pendulum bob given by mg. And we know the tension is maximized here because the speed of the pendulum bob is at its greatest value here because we're at the lowest point in the trajectory. So we have the greatest centripetal acceleration, v squared over r. And in addition, the force of gravity is directly opposed to the tension in this configuration. And that requires even more of the tension in order for our forces to sum to the required total value of the centripetal force. So we apply Newton's second law to the pendulum bob, and that's F net equals ma. And we're going to use a coordinate system in which upward is positive. So t counts as a positive, and I have a t minus mg. Mg counts as negative because it points downward. And that's equal to the mass of the pendulum bob times its acceleration. Again, the acceleration is going to be v squared over r, where v is the speed at the bottom of the trajectory. So we plug in v squared over r, where r is the radius of curvature. Well, that's just the length of the string in this case, and we called that L in the diagram. Then we have to ask, well, how do we find the speed at the bottom of the trajectory in terms of the initial height? And that's an energy conservation problem. In my initial state, I have gravitational potential energy. Using the lowest point as a reference point of zero, my initial y value is going to be h naught. So I have mg h naught. In my final state, that's all been converted to kinetic energy. And that's 1/2 mv². We cancel the m's out of this, and we multiply both sides by 2 and square root the result. And we find out that v is the square root of 2g h naught. Now getting back to our force equation, that v squared can be replaced with 2g h naught. Now we can solve in general for the height in terms of the tension at the bottom of the string. And to get this done, we're going to multiply both sides by L and then divide both sides by 2mg, isolating h naught on one side of the equation. Finally, we can plug in all our numbers. Make sure you convert that mass into kilograms. That's 0.180. G, we're going to use 9.8 for that. And what I'm assuming here is that my tension has been maxed out, so I'm plugging in that 2.2 newtons. In other words, we started this from the height that's just on the verge of breaking the string. Again, m is 0.180, and g is 9.8. And when I run the numbers on this, I get 0.185 meters. And we could write that as 18.5 centimeters. In part B, we're asked to compute the maximum speed of the pendulum bob when it's released from the height we computed in part A. Well, we already figured out how the speed depends on the initial height. That's the square root of 2g h naught. So we just plug the numbers in, and we obtain a maximum speed of 1.90 meters per second. Now I want to do one last thing in this problem. I want to go ahead and check the answer. So I want to see that an initial height of 0.185 meters actually gives me a tension of 2.2 newtons in the string. So I'm going to go back to the force analysis. That's T minus mg equals mv squared over L. And we'll solve that for T. And when I add mg to both sides of that, I can factor the m out. So I get m times the quantity g plus v squared over L. We plug in m, that was 0.180 kilograms, g, 9.8, v was 1.9, and that has to be squared, and L was 1.5. And when I run the numbers on this to three significant digits, it does round to 2.20 newtons, and we're done. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.